Guys, welcome to our Foundation JE channel. Today in this video, we are going to study unitary method in math. Guys, in this video, we will discuss two types of variations. First one is a direct variation and second one is a inverse variation, which are part of the unitary method. Then in this video we will also see definition and examples based on unitary method, direct variation and inverse variation. Now time to see unitary method. So guys, unitary method, guys, as you see, the name of the method is a unitary method. Okay, so in this method, what we will do, we will find out the value of unit quantity. Okay, now see the definition here. When we calculate value of unit / single quantity, then we calculate the value or quantity which we have required. Okay, so this method is known as unitary method. Okay guys, see here, a price of 6 books is 120 rupees. Okay, then what is the price of one book? Okay, so guys, what we will do here, we first write here price of 6 books equal to rupees of 120. So price of one book equal to rupees of 120 by 6, which is rupees of 20. Okay, so guys, see, if the price of the some quantities are given, and when you calculate the price of one unit, here I have calculated the price of one book here. So if you need suppose 12 books, okay, so what shall be the price? Okay, so price of 12 books. So guys, what you will do, rupees of 20, one unit rate, and just multiply by 12. So this one is a rupees of 240. So guys, this is the way the unitary may work here. Okay, next we will discuss direct variation, which is also a part of a unitary method. Now see the definition first. Direct variation. Okay, the definition: when two quantity whose ratio is fixed and there is a variation in one quantity accordingly value of second quantity vary. Okay guys, so what does mean by here? Okay, just we have previously seen a price of 6 books equal to rupees of 120. So price of one book equal to rupees of 120 by 6. So this one is a rupees of 20. Okay, so guys, here one quantity is price which is rupees of 120. Second quantity here, books, which is in 6 numbers. Okay, so guys, see, if you will see 120 by 6, then this ratio is 20. So this is a fixed now. Okay, so guys, in definition, when two quantity whose ratio is fixed, so this one is a fixed now, there is a variation in one quantity, accordingly value of second quantity vary in same proportion. Okay, so guys, what does mean here? This one, suppose now I need a 6 book here. Okay, again I need 3 more books here, so this becomes 9 here. Okay, so guys, what will be the factor we increases the book? See, 9 here, 6 here, so this becomes a 1, then 6, 3. Okay guys, 6 is greater than 3, so we put here 1 dot. You can see my earlier video how to make a division of a decimal number, link is given in a description box. Okay guys, now see, so when we put here 0, this becomes a 5, so 30, then this becomes 0. So when you increases 6 into 1.5 times the books, then this becomes 9. Accordingly, you can see the price of the 6 book is here 120. Now it is increases 1.5 times, so this becomes a what? 180. Okay, now guys, see here, 180 divided by 9, so this becomes also 20. Okay, this one, 9 ones are 1, here see, 9 twos are 18, again 0, so this becomes a 20. So what you guys see here, in the direct variation method, the ratio is fixed here. Okay, 20 and 20. So our definition here, there is a variation in one quantity, accordingly value of second quantity vary in same proportion. Proportion means here 1.5 times. Okay, so now guys, I think the definition of a direct variation clear to you. Next, see when we will take a mathematical example like x and y quantities. Okay, so guys, suppose in algebraic form x and y are two quantities which are example of direct variation which option is correct where k is constant. Okay guys, so first option is here 1 by k equal to xy. B option is here xy equal to k. C option is here 1 by x equal to ky, and other example is here y by k equal to x here guys. Okay, so guys, which option you prefer is example of a direct variation. So guys, see here, if this one left hand side k is going on right side, so this becomes 1 equal to kxy, so this one is a wrong. Okay, and for this one xy equal to k, so this one is also wrong because this one is a product of the two quantities. Now see here, if you will take this one, so this one also becomes 1 equal to kxy, so this one is also wrong. Okay, or for what about this one, so for this one y divided by x equal to k, so this one answer is correct. Okay, so in algebraic form y by x equal to k equal to constant is an example of a direct variation. Okay guys, why? Because in previous example you see when the price of the 6th book is 120, then this becomes a 20. In same proportion, if you increases 1.5 times both, again when books becomes the 9 in previous example, so this becomes 180 by 9. Now see this one, this becomes also 20. So what you see here, the both y by x is constant, so this is an example of a direct variation in algebraic form. Okay guys, now see more example in maths. So question number 1 here guys, price of 5 chocolates is rupees of 65. How much price of 7 chocolates? Okay guys, so solution here, first we write price of 5 chocolates equal to rupees of 65. So price of 1 chocolate equal to rupees of 65 divided by 5, this becomes 1, 5, 13 is 65, so this becomes rupees of 13. So guys, here see, we have calculated here a price of a 1 unit. Now so price of 7 chocolates equal to rupees of 13 equal into 7, this becomes rupees of 91. So this one is our answer. Okay, guys. Now see a question number 2, for example. Okay, a weight of 5 packets of rice is 17.5 kg. How many packets similar can be made from 28 kg rice? Okay. So guys, solution here. So guys, first of all we write weight of 5 packets of rice equal to what? 17.5 kg. So weight of 1 packet of rice equal to 17.5 divided by 5. Okay, so this becomes 3.5. Okay guys, how this is coming 3.5? For more clarity, see how to make division of a decimal number. Link of the earlier video is given in a description box. Second part of the question, how many packets can be made from 28 kg? Okay, so we write here number of packets can be made from 28 kg equal to what? 28 divided by 3.5 kg. okay, so guys, this will come 8. Guys, see, when you solve any question of division, then units must be same. Here is kg, here is also kg. So kg, kg cancel out. So now only units becomes number. So this becomes 8 here. Okay. Now guys, see another question. Question number 3. A pump runs 1 minute 20 second, then fill up 4/5 part of a drum. How much time it will take to fill up similar 7 drums? So solution, as per question here, 4/5 part of drum fill by pump equal to 1 minute 20 second here. Okay guys, so first of all you convert this minute and second in one unit. So now we convert it into a second. So guys, you know 1 minute equal to what? 60 second. Okay, then we make a addition sign plus a 20 second here. Okay, so this becomes 80 second. Okay, so next, pump run to fill 1 drum equal to 80 second divided by 4/5. Okay guys, so this becomes here 80, then this 4/5 becomes what? 5 by 4. So this becomes what here? 20. So 100 second. Okay. So guys, this time is required to fill up the one drum. So time to run the pump to fill up 7 drums equal to what? 100 into 7. This is in second, so this becomes 700 second. Okay guys, so see here, we are using a unit tree method here. For one drum first, then we calculated the required 7 drum. So guys, what is the value of this 700 second minute and second? So guys, see here, first we write here 700, then if we are going to calculate in minutes, so we divide 60, so this becomes 1, this becomes 60, now this becomes what? 10, 0, this becomes 1, this becomes 60, this becomes 40. So guys, see this number 700 by 60, so this is going to convert into minutes, or this is also in second, so remainder is here is also second. So time taken, or you can say time to run the pump to fill up 7 drums equal second. So this is our solution here. Okay guys, next we will see inverse variation. Okay, now definition. If two quantities are inversely proportional to each other or vice versa, then such variation is called inverse variation. Guys, see by a simple example in daily life, suppose a car whose speed say 20 km per hour uniform. Okay, means there is no change in speed. Okay, now in 6 hours, how much distance it will travel? 120 km. Okay, now suppose here 120 km is a fixed or say constant distance. Okay, so guys, 20 km per hour into 6 hours, okay, equal to what? 120 km. If the driver increases the speed 40 km per hour, or you can say 2 times of initial speed, then how much it will take time to travel 120 km? So you will say it will take 3 hours. Okay, so guys, what you see here, if there is a variation of one quantity, then second one is also inversely affect the other one. Okay, so guys, see here, inverse variation in algebraic form, how could you write? Okay, here suppose P and Q are two quantities, okay, are inversely proportional to each other, then how could you write in mathematical form? So we write here first P, then this one is a proportional to 1 by Q. Why 1 by Q? Because we are talking about a inverse variation. So in inverse variation, the numerator will be 1 and numerator the quantity will be come. Okay. Suppose if you remove this one proportional to symbol by a constant, say L, it is known as a proportionality constant. Okay, guys, for your future aspect, you remember these things. The proportionality constant does not depend upon the two variables P and Q here. Okay, or you can say two quantities. Okay, so if you remove this proportional to here symbol, then PQ equal to L, or you can also say P equal to L by Q, guys. Okay, or you can also say here Q equal to L by P, where L is a constant quantity. Okay, or say value. See here, if the distance is fixed here 120, then it does not depends upon the this two one, speed and hours. Okay, now see some examples or for your better understanding. Question: if X and Y are two quantities and vary inversely proportional to each other and their proportionality constant is K, which is an example of inverse variation. Okay guys, so option A is here 1 by X equal to Y KY. Okay, and second option B is here X equal to KY. C option is here Y by X equal to K here, and D option is here Y equal to K by X, which is an example of inverse variation. Okay, so guys, in first case we can write it as a K into XY, which is incorrect. Okay, you have seen PQ equal to what? L. Okay, so this does not satisfy this rule, okay? Only the variables, or you can say literals, changes x and y, here p and q, or k is a proportionality constant, here l is a proportionality constant. In this case, see, this also not an example of this one, x equal to ky, so this one is also wrong. What about this? This becomes y equal to kx, okay? So this one is also wrong, okay? Now see this one, this becomes, if this denominator on right side come on left side numerator, then it becomes multiplication, then xy equal to what? K. So see, this one and this one is similar to each other, only literals are varying, okay? So this answer is correct, okay? So guys, now see another example, question number 2. Suppose if 18 men construct a wall in 24 days, how many more men are required to complete construction of wall in 16 days? So solution here, first we write here 18 men construct a wall in 24 days, okay? So guys, here one man can construct same wall in how many days? 18 into 24 days, okay? Now suppose x men construct same wall in 16 days, okay? So one man construct same wall in how many days? 16 into x days, okay? Or you can say here equal to 16x days, okay? If you remove from the here, okay? Now one man construct same wall equal to 16x days. Guys, we are here discussing unitary method, so you know one man can construct same wall into 18 into 24 days. So in this case also, one man construct same wall equal to 16x days, okay? So what we will do in such types of cases or problem, we equate unit quantity, okay? So 16x equal to what? 18 into 24, okay? Here guys, say here days, here also days will come, okay? So units are same, so we can write it as a 18 into 24, okay? So here x becomes what? 18 into 24 by 16, so this becomes 9 into 3 divided by 1, or this equivalent to 9 into 3 equal to 27. So x is now what? 27 men, okay? Now, as per our question, more men. So, more men required to complete wall construction in 16 days equal to what? In this case, we need 27 men and initially we have 18 men. So, difference is 9. So, if we will add 9 more men, then this wall construction will be completed in 16 days. So, our solution is 9 men. Now, see another example. Question number 3. Suppose this one is a field here. Okay. This one is a field. Okay. Now, suppose 25 bullocks plug this field 4 hours daily plugging for 18 days. Okay, this one is a failure, guys. Okay, suppose the farmer think the load on the blocks are more and he also think to complete the plugging of this field in 12 days. Okay, so now next one is how many more bullocks to be required to complete plugging 3 hours daily for 12 days. Okay guys, so our solution in this case, first we write a statement here, 25 bullocks plug the field 4 hours daily for 18 days. Okay, now same work or plugging 1 bullock will complete plug the field equal to what? 25 into 4 hours into 18 days. Okay. Now, suppose here X bullocks plug the field 3 hours daily in 12 days. Okay, so 1 bullock plug the field in how many days? X into 3 hours into 12 days. Okay guys, so we can remove also this one here. Now see, this one and this one is now unit quantity, means in this case also 1 bullock will complete the plug the field 25 into 4 hours into 18 days. Now in this case also one block plug the field equal to x into 3 hours into 12 days. So both are in unit quantity. So we equate the both one. So we can write here x into 3 hours into 12 days equal to what? 25 into 4 hours into 18 days. Guys, I am writing here units because in more complicated question, the hours may be given in minutes. So you have to convert this hour in minutes also. Okay. So this is a simple question here. So units are same here. Okay. See. So you can also remove the units also. Here I am removing the units on both the sides. So simple this one. Okay. Now you can write it as a 25 into 2. This one is a 50. So 50 blocks will perform this work, working 3 hours daily for 12 days. Now our question is here, how many more blocks are required? So more blocks required to complete plugging 3 hours daily for 12 days equal to what? Now 50 and minus 25, this is 25. So our answer is here 25 blocks more required to complete this plugging of field by working 3 hours daily for 12 days. Guys, hope you enjoyed this video by listening and watching. Please like and subscribe this Foundation JEE channel. Thank you very much.